What's going on YouTube? Uberman here. So today we're going to put the drive shaft in the Jeep so that we can get 4x4 working again. I've got someone coming to look at it in about an hour and a half. And this person's already looked at it once. So it's important we get it finished today. So sometimes you got to work in unfavorable conditions. Today it's about 36 degrees outside. It is raining. We're supposed to have some sleet and stuff later. It's supposed to get even colder. This is not a great day to be working on vehicles, but we got to get it done, so let's knock it out. Garage is becoming a mess. It's about time we get out here and clean this up. Ooh, it's cold. All right, we got the wheel chocks in place. Got the drive shaft over here. Let's get started. Let me tell you something, guys. It is cold as shit out here today. Well, this went on a whole lot easier the first time.
Take your new drive shaft and feed it back up into place. And you want to feed it in the back end first and push the back end up and over where it's supposed to go. And keep the front end in. Then you can now lower that back end down in place.
I'll tell you what, thank God for YouTube, right? I just watched a YouTube video to show me how to put this thing back into place because I just couldn't get it to fit. And there we go. All right, guys, so that's a wrap. The Jeep is fixed. I'm very happy. I am pretty certain now that I am the one that blew up the drive shaft. That was probably my fault because I don't know how to use the four-wheel drive in this. But I can tell you that when I come to a stop, put it in neutral and put it in four high and then put it in drive, everything is smooth as butter. Same thing when I go to put it in two-wheel drive, I come to a stop, put it in neutral, put it down in two, back in drive, smooth as butter. So probably my fault I broke the drive shaft. You live, you learn. I'll remember that in case I ever run into another Jeep Liberty or another Jeep like this in general with the same type of four-wheel drive system. She's running and driving great. I've got her listed on Craigslist and Facebook Marketplace for $2,500, so it should sell quick. I'm ready to get this thing sold and move on to some new projects because we do have more things to look at come Tuesday and Wednesday, and I'm kind of excited. So until then, give this video a thumbs up. If you like the content, please comment below. I read them all, even if I can't respond to all of them. It's been a busy few days. But please leave me a like, leave me a comment. Stay safe out there. Happy Easter, and I'll catch you in the next one.